We're going to compare building an app with Tempo on the left and Lovable on the right. By the end of the video, we're going to see which one did a better job. We're going to use the same prompt for both apps. I'm using the prompt, I want to build a bill splitting app to make it easier to split bills with my friends. And we're going to do the same on both the left and the right. Now for Tempo, they give you the option to easily connect to Stripe or Supabase or other databases. But I'm not going to use that functionality right now. We're just going to build everything just on the browser locally. So just to show you kind of what happens right off the bat, Tempo on the left side here, what they do when you send it a prompt is it will automatically generate a PRD, a product requirements document. It generates a mermaid diagram to show the user flow. It creates wireframes. So it kind of goes through more prep, at least that it shows the user before getting started with actually building out your project. Now, Lovable, on the other hand, it may do these things behind the scenes, but here we can see on the left side, it kind of comes up with design inspiration, features, design elements, and writes it out. And then it's already starting to code here. So here we are over in Tempo, and I can see it is generating the, well, actually, first, if you go here to the left side, you can see the PRD that it created, the user flow, all of that. If we go over to the design, we can see kind of the designs of what it's building. So right off the bat, I can already see, I think Tempo might be doing a bit of a better job, especially on this initial prompt, than Lovable did, which I'm very impressed with because Lovable usually has really amazing designs on its first prompt. And then if I go to the code, we can see the code that was actually written. Then if we go to the top and click View App in New Tab, we can actually preview the app that Tempo built. So we have, let's say the same thing, the bill was 100. Interesting that it lets you add a tip. And then you can do an even split or a custom split. So if we do an even split with three people, pretty cool. So it has the total, added the tip. So it looks like it added three people, even though it really would have been split it by four people. But I like how it kind of added these avatars. I guess it made up these names. But then if I go back, so number of people, let's say two, is it going to update it? So it looks like there might be a little bit of an issue there. It looks like it just has kind of like, it might not actually be working right now. Like if I make it 500 with two people. So that may have just been the default. Let me refresh the page and see if, yeah. Okay. So it looks like it kind of created designs, but it didn't create the logic yet. So difference between Lovable and Tempo is Tempo created the design, which I really like, but it doesn't look like the logic is there yet. So I'm going to go back to the page on Tempo. Let's go down to the bottom and say the design looks great, but can you add the logic so it all works? And then on Lovable side, what I'm going to do is say, make sure that I can clear out the split and start over. Also add a, why don't I say a history tab. Okay, so on the left side, I've asked Tempo to continue building out the functionality and also ensure that when I say split by three people, it's three people including me, which maybe wasn't necessary because that seemed to be test data in the beginning. But then if I go over to Lovable, so now it should have a history, it has a clear, so let's see how this works. So here, if I click split evenly, it seems to do a good job with that. And then if I add another person and click split evenly, it'll update it, which is cool. And then if I go to history, that is there. So that works, but it doesn't seem to have a good job of letting me like update the percentages or change the kind of split it not evenly. So I'm going to say splitting evenly works great. Can you make it work better? Not splitting evenly if it's... Okay, so let's just start with that and see how it goes. And now let's see how Tempo did with the updates it made. So let's add a bill, 150. Let's say tip. That's fine. We can add that for now. Number of people, let's say five. And let's calculate the split. Be sure to stick around because I was surprised what happens next when I keep building with Tempo. And you're also going to learn tips of how to debug in the best way with Lovable and Tempo. Cool. I really like this. So let's go back and let's change it to 250 and just make sure that it's working. It is. Okay, awesome. And then if I can say tip was included, so zero. Perfect. Okay, great. And then Let's say I switch to custom split. Let's see how that works. I'm curious what the. So let's say I put in 100 for person one, like what it does. So the custom split doesn't seem to do anything. It only works for the even split right now. But the even split worked really well, and I like the design better than lovable. So here, lovable, let's check out how it did with improving that custom split functionality. That seems to be the part that's a little bit trickier. So let's say we have a description, $200. We put in a few people. Can I add numbers here? So let's say 100. And then there's 100 left. So if I calculate the split, then what happens? So I think what we need to do is I'll ask it to allow us to add custom items from a receipt and assign to a person for a custom split, because that's what's going to allow us to actually do that custom split, because it's either split evenly or you need to know what everyone ordered. So I'm going to do the same thing here in Tempo. All right, so let's see here what Lovable did. I think I really like what it did here. So if it's 250 and we add two people here to the bill and we add an item, we'll say pasta, we'll add an item, we'll say pizza. Why don't we change this to like 50? And then pasta was 30, pizza was 20. And then let's add, drink for 10, and we'll add another drink that was 5, let's say. So the pasta will assign, it's automatically pulling in the people, which is pretty cool. The drink, let's just assign to various people. And then let's see what happens. If I click assign items, there we go. So it worked perfectly. 30 plus 10, 20 plus 5. Pretty cool. And if I click calculate split, it saves it in the history, I think it's supposed to. Yes. Cool. That functionality was actually really good. So now let's go over to Tempo. I believe it's finished with everything, unless it has a couple more subtasks. So Tempo works a little bit more slowly. So I'm going to say yes, complete the subtasks. Let me know when the custom split functionality is done. So I'll pause the video. Okay, so Tempo says it completed the work. Let's check out how it completed this. So if I put a bill total of 100, let's just say 0 tip percentage. We're going to do the itemized split type. That's the what we want. Custom split really doesn't seem to do much. So then let's add some items. Pizza, 25. We can add pasta, 20. We can add soup for 5. And then let's add two people. And by default, it just has person one and person two. And if I assign and click done, it doesn't seem, there seems to be a bug where it's clicking that, but then, okay, so I think it is assigned, but it's not showing us in the UI. But let's try it anyway. I'll calculate it. So that did work. Yes, it worked. It showed it. So the only thing I need to ask for, I really like it actually, but we need to improve this assign. So what I want this to be more like lovable where it's a drop down. I think that's visually better. So I'm going to ask for that. So I said, can we make the assign items a drop down to the user to visually show who is assigned in the UI? So let's check out Tempo. We'll put in a bill total. We'll go to itemized. We'll add pizza, 20. We'll add pasta. Doesn't really matter. Let's just say 80 for this example. And then here, interesting, I can click manage assignments. So if I have a person one and then manage assignments person two. So it says assigned. I still would prefer to show. Oh, it does show here. Okay. Not the best UI, but like I think Lovable just did it in like a really simple way. I feel like this is a little over-engineered on the Tempo side. Let's go ahead and click calculate split. And yeah, so here it goes. It added the tip to everyone and everything like that. So pretty cool. So which one do you think did a better job building out this tool? I think both of them have its pros and cons. I think that Tempo did a better job at building out the initial design, adding more functionality. The history design is better. It did over-engineer things a little bit, I think, especially with the itemized and how it kind of assigned the user. I think that Lovable did a really good job of quickly building this out in a very simple and elegant way. I really like how it included these dropdowns. So I really like how Lovable built this a little bit more simply. So what I would say is for an app that you want to just get something done very quickly, a quick internal tool, use Lovable. If you want to build something out a little bit more, especially if you don't have the technical expertise to know what to ask Lovable, then I would go with Tempo because Tempo automatically builds out that product requirements document. It automatically is going to kind of come up with more feature ideas. So I think Tempo is better if you want to build out something more fully functional, at least as of this video. Again, these tools are changing very quickly, so you need to constantly be testing them to see which one is best. So be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more content like this. We're constantly doing tests like this and showing you which AI app builders are best for different projects. Click the link in the description to go to No Code MBA. No Code MBA is an online learning platform teaching you how to build AI and no code apps from scratch, taught by industry experts. So if you want to go a lot deeper than what this video did, click the link in the description and check out the courses and see if it's something that you'd be interested in. Leave a comment below if you have any questions at all, and we'll see you in the next video.